So here with Councillor Jackie O'Quinn, Goldsmid Ward, Councillor for the Labour Party on Brighton Hove City Council. Welcome back, Jackie. Happy
Hello,
New Year.
Hello, Mark. It's nice to see you.
We're going to start off by talking a bit about what you're doing in the committees and that at the council. I know you've been looking into kind of the anti-racism strategy. Tell us what that consists of.
Yeah, well, I think the anti-racism strategy was something that was fairly straightforward, going to be taught in personal social and health education in schools. I'm still not sure from what age that is going to be done. But then that was developed and we had this sort of announcement that we were going to be doing this through the lens of critical race theory. And, you know, and I actually had to go away and look up what this was because I hadn't heard of it before. And I did make some points at the committees about the fact that, you know, already quite a lot was taught about race in schools, you know, that you would teach, you know, civil rights in the United States. I'm sure slavery is taught. All these things, I think, are generally taught in schools. But I know one of the officers said, oh, well, you know, that it would tend to be the students who might be doing history and might be doing, you know, a GCE or A-level in it. You know, and I accept that. But I certainly, when I was at school as a littlie of 7 and 8, you know, I was finding out about things like slavery and so on. And already beginning to question things. Or not question so much as realise that there was an issue with it, that it wasn't a right thing to do morally. And so I went and looked up a whole load of stuff about this and, you know, found it very difficult. And what I could work out was it did stem in the United States, it has come from America, from the civil rights movement. And a lot of work was done in the 70s and 80s. But looking at law, because it was felt that the discrimination against black people in the United States was deeply embedded in American law. And so lots of studies were done on this. You know, they looked at it in various universities and so on. And then this idea, you know, sort of developed that critical race theory is all about that, you know, institutions are essentially racist, that we sort of have to question, well, you know, they are racist, so how do we get rid of that racism? That's as I understand it. And then it wasn't even taught in American schools. It's only recently that this has happened, and it's caused immense controversy in the United States, which I have to say is utterly different to the UK. Parents have a lot more power in schools in the United States, a lot more. They can dictate what books are in schools and so on. You can't do that here. Parents don't have that sort of range of power in a school. And it seems that a lot of the, how can I put it, perhaps the more conservative states, a lot of the southern states, Republican states, are finding this very difficult, and are interpreting it as an attack on them because it talks about white superiority. And reading some of the stuff, you know, where some of the states have basically banned it from being taught in schools, that actually it's made it quite difficult for teachers because are you still able to teach about the civil rights movement in the United States without going against this ban on critical race theory?
Yeah.
Because essentially, personally, I think all young people in America should really know about the history of race in their country. And it isn't just black people, it's Indians and so on, the indigenous people of India, of America. And so it's come out, it's only started being taught in America recently. I don't know where else it's taught in the UK. I think probably not many places at the moment. What I'm struggling to understand is how we have translated the critical race theory from states to the UK, which is different. It is, we are different. And like I said, to adapt it to kind of get at the issues we have in our society, because they are very different.
Yeah.
we didn't have that sort of tremendous discrimination in law. I would say in this country, you know, common law, which was developed, you know, in, I think it was under the reign of Henry VIII, and it's about property. Everything is about property in this country.
It seems to be.
The property yeah, is yeah. more important than the person, and yeah. there are more laws about property, yeah. and that was to make sure yeah. that all those robber barons kept all their ill-gotten gains. But so we don't have that. We you know, women had to fight hard for the vote, but there isn't history here of not letting black people have votes or people of colour or, you know, different people have the vote.
Yeah.
So that's why I called the other day for the material to be available to us as to what's being taught in schools, because I want to see how it's been adapted for the UK.
Yeah.
You know, what exactly is going to be presented to the children in this, or young people. And I was disturbed by the fact that there were several councillors who asked for this material and were refused. And one of the reasons given was commercial sensitivity. And I think that's very difficult in an education setting to say we can't let you look at what's being taught to children and young people because it's commercially sensitive. Because as far as I'm concerned, it should all be open to view, because, you know, it's there's a lot of power in education. You're influencing yeah. young people quite dramatically. You have to be so careful as a teacher. And personally, I know I always, it was debate to develop critical thinking skills for students, to get them to realise that it's really good to argue with somebody who doesn't agree with you, you know. So you're developing those skills, but you're also trying to get them to see the world, how can I put it, in a more critical way, not to just sort of go along blindly with, you know, it's not even bigotry often, it's just a bias. So, you know, it's that idea of unconscious bias.
Yeah.